Whoop, whoop, whoop. I know. It's like Tiffany really in the dark. And well, you know, here's the truth. I am well on my way. Dun, 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 dun. Tomorrow I take my clients to, take some of our clients and Rise Elite to Cuba. We're headed out of the country. And as I was sitting here having a quick conversation, I'll leave this as a mystery. We'll leave this as a surprise. Can we leave you as a surprise? Do we leave you as a surprise? Here's what's really real. I gotta tell you, you know, procrastination is really, really tough. And one of the ways that we sabotage ourselves is that we procrastinate. Like, we keep putting things off. We keep saying tomorrow, next week, next month, next year. Man, you know, I look back at my life and I think to myself, here's why we're going to Cuba. I said to myself the other day, I heard some of the things on the bucket list from some of our clients, and I thought, it's so easy to say, yeah, we can go there in three, four years from now, when times are better, when we make more money, when we have space. But you know what I've learned? Man, so much happens when you make a decision to act now. And when you make a decision to act now, and it's independent of other people. I can't tell you how many adults, how many women, how many people simply put themselves second in the conversation instead of putting themselves first. You know what I'm talking about? It's like you've got your friends, you've got your family, you've got employees, you've got neighbors, you've got sister, maybe you've got a spouse, maybe you have children. And yes, I understand the want to put everybody first. I get that. But then what about you? How can you constantly put yourself second? You know, I used to have a tough time with putting myself first, because I felt like I was being selfish. I felt like I was being self-absorbed. I felt like I was just not really taking care of the bigger picture if I put myself first, or even if I even just thought about myself. But what a game changer it was for me when I started taking care of me first. And I don't mean going to get a pedicure and a massage and all that stuff. That's maintenance for me. The other day I heard a woman tell me, she's like, oh, I schedule me time. I'm like, no, that's not me time. That's maintenance. That's not me time. I'm talking about where you schedule time to literally stop and go away. When you schedule time to fly across the country to just sit and kick the tires around with a girlfriend. You know, when we allow ourselves to be a vessel where we give energy and we get energy, we create energy, it's like magic happens. Every single time you get up and you serve the world and you serve people, especially if you're in a service-based business like I am, and you give and you give and you give to other people, it's like, you know, if you don't give back to yourself, and I really mean serve yourself, and let me tell you how you serve yourself. You serve yourself by giving yourself your heart's desires. And you know what I'm talking about? Dot, for sure. It's like, it's a matter of independence, but it's also a matter of serving yourself first. It's like, how can you be in a service-based business? You're serving everybody else, but you don't serve you. It's like you're almost a little bit hypocritical. It's like you almost put yourself in a place where you're missing out on the key ingredient. You're missing out on the number one most important thing that you could possibly do to grow yourself, to grow your platform. Yeah, it is maintenance. Let me tell you, for the women out there, this is a public service announcement courtesy of Onwards to Freedom and Tiffany Largie. Doing your nails is not me time. That's maintenance. Doing your feet is not me time. That's maintenance. Going and getting your hair done, maybe once in a while we can say it me time if you're getting it cut and colored and you're spending 6 hours there, I get it. But for me, that's maintenance. There is absolutely no me time in that. Me time is me having a bottle of wine, really good wine, some cheese, fruit, and my friends. Me time is me hanging out with Ashley and going to a game where we can just talk. I was going to say talk about the things that we're seeing. How do you say that and be politically correct? We could just talk about things that entertain us and make us laugh. That's fair, right? That's super solid. Now, me time is me heading out to take a trip that I've always wanted to take, to see a country. I gotta tell you this, not enough people are taking the time to serve themselves and to be selfish. And so therefore, they're serving the world, they're giving to other people, they're creating things for other people, but they don't tap into their heart's desires. But their heart's desires inside of this is what lies the creativity that we need to create the magic that we do when we serve other people. Where am I going? I'm going to Cuba. Tomorrow I head to Cuba. I'm taking some of our clients inside of Onwards to Freedom. And it was a surprise trip until about 2 days ago. They knew they were going away and they knew they were going out of country, but they didn't know where they were going. We're headed to Cuba. Absolutely. Oops, there's another one of those things. And now Dot will show how this is done wrong. No, this is not. Absolutely not. Here's what's real. I love you enough to say this. I lost a lot of time in my life because I served other people in a way that didn't really matter. I lost a lot of time. Hey, Mark, how you doing? Mark, I was just thinking about you. You know what? I'm taking some of my clients to Cuba tomorrow. So as a surprise. And I was thinking about our conversation in New Zealand. How you doing? So anyhow, you know, what's real is that we constantly serve. You know, Mark, you're actually a really good steward of this. You sure are. Serving yourself is not optional. It's one of those things that it has to be worked into what you do on a regular basis, and it cannot be rooted in the items that are called maintenance. Because then if we run empty and we run dry, do you know what we give other people? We give other people the leftovers. We give other people the bits and pieces that are now running on fumes. We give other people the bits and pieces that are stale and that are old. We give bits and pieces people the things that are not fresh. I want every client that works with us to get the freshest part of my mind. I want every team member, every contractor, I want every event attendee to get the freshest part of who I am. And here's my question and challenge to you. Do you give everyone that you love the freshest part of yourself, or do you give them what's left over? Do you give everybody that you love and you care about? Because typically when we're working, we've got to drive, we've got to grind, and it's a lot of work, and it takes a lot out of us. But I don't want to go and talk to the people who I love, like the people who I work with, or the people who support our events, or even our clients. I don't want to give them the leftover version. I don't. And for me, my clients, half of them are friends, and half of them we just work with. And it's like, I don't want to give any of them. I want to give all of them the freshest part of me. My challenging question to you is, do you give your clients, do you give your world, do you give your family, do you give the people at your church, do you give your team members the freshest part of you? Are you giving them what's left over? You know, we just started a beta group. Dot, you should be in that beta group, by the way. Brian, you're in the beta 8, and isn't it amazing so far? Isn't it really good so far, guys? It's like, you know, what's real about this beta is that I had this moment where I said, we totally could just create this idea, see how it'll work, and then offer it to people right after there. But I said to myself, you know, I'd really want to serve people a little bit harder, stronger, and more. So let's just open it up. Let's run this program live. We have no idea what will happen, but we do know what we're doing. And inside of that, I'm going to bring the best and amazing minds to the table. And I'm going to allow them to be coached along the way. I think it's like, it's under $100. It's like, it's one of the craziest things we've ever done as a company. But it was a lesson for me because it highlighted the power of now, number one. Number two, I wanted those people who needed us to get the freshest version versus what we sell next year. That's number two. And number three, I want it to be as much as integrity as I possibly can, because, you know, the last thing I want to do is put something out into the world that's not the freshest of our mind and the freshest of what's current. I could have used old technology, old information, old content that we had. But running it live has Anne, I love it. I love how you're participating. And Dot, you totally should be inside of it. It's amazing. You should talk to Anne. She's in it. You totally should. And if you're in Freedom 52, you get like some special, you get special something. So absolutely you should join in. It's 8 weeks of literally how to start your business, how to jump it off out of the ground. And Sherelle is running it 100%. And it is live. It is day by day, hour by hour. And it is simple steps in which, yeah, for sure. It is simple steps in which we're showing you how to do, simply do the damn thing. Ah ha ha ha, there goes the shirt. There goes the shirt. All right, so inside of that, my kind of late night question to you is, as I'm driving, I'm not driving, let me put that up. That's all I need is on social media to say that I'm the one driving. And then I'm going to have, you know, many people write to say, I can't believe you took that video while you were driving. How dare you? I'm reporting. You know what woman told me? She reported me. And I was like, I'm not driving. I can't drive and do this at the same time. I am looking at you though. I've made a decision for myself in 2019 that I do not want to give anyone any parts of me that are stale. And I don't just mean friends and family. I even mean the people who I work with, the people who are my partners, and more importantly, yeah, totally talk to Cheryl. Totally. Just reach out to her. She'll totally plug you and connect it in. She's running it for our entire community, and it's pretty flipping.